Maricor Aquino, she's the OIC of the school today, this week. Si Ma'am Maricor Aquino. Si Ma'am Pilar Ahadi. Yes. And we also have Ma'am Erica Espina. So, good afternoon, class.
Good afternoon, teacher Judith and visitors.
Okay. Today, we will have a debate. And this debate is part of our lesson on adverbs of affirmation and negation. The objective of our lesson is for you to be able to use adverbs of affirmation and negation in your statements. So when we have this debate today, you should be able to use words and expressions of affirmation and negation when you give your opinions, your statements, your agreements and disagreements. Okay? The subject of our debate today is detecting bias. Okay, so the poem I have given you, which is entitled Man and Woman, that is what we are going to resolve today. Is there bias in the reading material I gave you? Is there bias in the poem? Okay. Now, for the rest of the class who are observers, you are going to observe, and I will ask you later if the team, each member of the team was able to use expressions of affirmation and negation. You may also express your opinion of which team are do you pay vote for, which team do you side for. Okay, so are we ready? We have here this side of this team, and this side for bias, and that other side for anti-bias. Okay, shall we start?
Yes.
Okay, let's start.
Before we start this debate, please call on the first speaker. Hear, hear.
Hear, 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 hear.
So, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I will start the speech with a quote. We treat people the way we see them and the manner by which we create them is what they become. By Johan van Vogt. We people judge the person physically as what we can see them. We don't bother to think why they are act like that or why they used to do things that they are doing. Let me differentiate the gender equality and the gender inequality. Gender equality means that everyone should receive equal treatment and not discriminated against based on their gender. While gender inequality refers to unequal treatment or perceptions of individuals based on their genders. As I have read the poem by Victor Hugo titled Men and Women, I've heard many things that totally broke my heart. Actually, because all of the statement here really emphasizes a difference between a man and a woman. Why? Even women can be a brave, can be strong, can have their ability to be a hero, to have a supremacy, can be genius, to be a home, to think, to be an ocean, a flying eagle, or even a temple. The poem really emphasizes and totally emphasizes that a woman can be what a man can be. To say that, this poem is totally biased. Let's inspire people with what we thought here. It's gender inequality. Is the problem of the nation that every man and woman is subdivided by a demarcation. Ladies and gentlemen, let's turn strength and the laws of our nation. Let's promulgate new things that even one should have a limit solution. It's the future of the next generation. Toleration will never have a space in this nation. We don't have to tolerate people who are keeping on making a demarcation between a woman and a man. It's time to stop these misleading words of some institution. Some man who wanted to gain an exact money for their work that affects the room use of the nation. With that, Madam Chair, I rest my statement.
Point, Miss Speaker,
can you state evidence or lying in the bill where it shows gender inequality or unequal treatment? And please kindly explain why did you say so?
Okay. Man thinks and woman dreams. Are you guys saying that a woman can think, that a woman are living in the fantasy life that are keeping on dreaming and not to think of things? So what I am emphasizing here with the case that my speech meant is that also a woman can think and also a man dream. Okay? That's what I am saying here. Okay.
Jane, hindi ko pwede mag-point.
Ma'am,
hindi ko pwede mag-point.
Okay, so thank you for the first speaker. Can you up on the next speaker?
Here.
Shame.
The opposition side is highly opposing the motion, which is the vote contains biases regardless about the genders for the men and women. The vote man and woman is just a generalization about what most people think about man and woman. We didn't say that man is just only the brain. It's just said that man is for the brain and women for the heart. It doesn't said, or the vote doesn't said that women is just for the heart and man is for the brain. That's what we're trying to fight for. Because ladies and gentlemen, Madam Chair, and most of the members of this house, the poll generalize what usually men thinks about themselves and what usually people think about women. It's based on the survey and based on psychologies. Man is most on brain and women is based on the heart, because women are usually emotional. So going back, ladies and gentlemen, that's why humans are separated into two categories, the man and the woman, due to their physical appearance in terms of their capacity, strength, and weaknesses, ladies and gentlemen. Madam Chair, our group is very broad enough to understand the poll in a very deep way. That's why we don't take it literally like the other group is doing so. The book doesn't contain biases. We believe in that. We highly believe in that. And we are firm in our beliefs that the book doesn't contain any biases. Yes, they were described and differentiate from each other, but then there's two cases and evidences that the book also underestimate the woman and discriminate man. The poll also didn't say that all men is like this and all women is like this. Like for example, man is the brain, woman is the heart. The poll doesn't emphasize that women is just only the brain and man doesn't have a heart. And same thing to the woman. Based on psychology, most of the man is good in terms of intelligence, while woman is more unconscious in their heart. In other words, most of the man is physical and women is internal or emotional. The anti-bias group is standing here in front of you all, Madam Chair, most of the members of this house, that the poll is not all about biases in terms of gender, but based on the title itself, man and woman, men being generalized what most people think about the characteristics of every individual. And because of that, we believe that there's no biases, because we created oppositely, and we believe that opposite sex attracts. That's why we created men and God created women. Yes.
I don't care about the psychology says or something. Is that reliable or I think it's not reliable? So what do people think? Is the point what do people think? It's Victor Hugo. Victor Hugo made the point. That's why he should be the one to be considered and not the people itself.
Mr. Speaker, psychology is the study of human characteristics and human use. So therefore we believe that what psychology says is very realistic and based on reality. Ladies and gentlemen, do you think that man is somehow emotional, but they don't show it because man believes that if they are truly a man, they would show it to the women because that is their characteristic and that is the difference, that is their...
Thank you for that. Thank you. So now let's listen to the next speaker. You're here.
Here.
Ladies and gentlemen, with that, Madam Chair, what we are fighting here is we wanted to have a win-win solution. As what our Prime Minister was saying earlier, Duman doesn't have heart, doesn't have peers. We're not more peers. This doesn't have preferences. Can't be an angel. Can't be a gospel. To have a dream, to be a lady, a singing nightingale in the shrine. Now, after all that I have said earlier, are you going to still fight that the boy does not have bias? Most of your members are women. Do you guys doesn't feel even a little pain in your heart after you've read the point? Because as what our Prime Minister said, this point really emphasized demarcation and subdivided men and women. For short, it shows bias. With that, Madam Chair, I rest.
1 minute to speak.
1 minute. Next speaker, please.
Here. The boy has no bias because it only describes the characteristic that a woman and a man has. It didn't say that the boy is that the man is stronger than a girl. It said that a man is strong, but it didn't say that a girl is not also strong. It's only saying that we have our own characteristic and a boy is more stronger than a girl. It is only describing. But it didn't say that one doesn't have that characteristic. It's only saying that one is having this kind of ability. It's only describing. Next, just for example, man is a code, a woman a gospel. A code corrects and a gospel perfects. In that sense, we can see that we have all different. But the fact is, it was distributed fairly. Be realistic, ladies and gentlemen. Just don't focus on the words that I use. Instead, understand it well. Because if you can just understand it well, the point shows no bias. That was it. Thank you for that. Let's now welcome the next speaker, Junior.
So, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I do really believe that the poem entitled Man and Woman has a bias. It's how the author described the man from woman. For example, man is an ocean, woman a lake. Can you see, for all of us, that there are a big difference from an ocean and a lake. Ocean is more wider and lake is narrower. And it was clearly that there was a bias. So, as what our Prime Minister said, gender equality means that everyone should receive equal treatment. and not be discriminated against for their gender. And with that, I end my speech.
Thank you. Now let's listen to the next speaker.
We're here.
Before I start the speech, I just want to add to your speech. He said a while ago, ocean. Land is the ocean. Woman is the lake. So as you can see, if you just compare ocean to lake, ocean is wider than lake. But they have different characteristics as it is, as that are suitable for men and women.
You're here.
Okay. So let's start. Obviously, the point is not biased, because the definitions are really applicable and suitable for men and women.
You're here.
But we're not telling you that that all men are strong, for example, or all men are genius than women, or etc. But it was only emphasized here because most of the men are strong. Another example. Man is the brain, woman is the heart. The brain creates time, the heart love. Which shows that most of the men are solving their problems using their brain, for example. Because they believe that brain creates time, and this time can be the way to their success. But I'm not telling you that the man is more powerful than women. Because woman has this heart that can use in solving other problems, just like man. Because a heart creates love that can care for others. Which means they have different characteristics. And also, if you just analyze the poll, the definitions are equal based on their characteristics. Characteristics as man or woman. For you, it's an equality because you make it literal as it is. Always remember, the point is not always always. The point has always had this narrow or other definitions, not literal as you make it. So in that case, I stand here with the opposition, which is the poem is not biased.
Thank you for that. So let's now welcome the next speaker. You're here.
First of all, good evening. We all know that man and a woman have different capacities, responsibilities, capabilities of something. Before to be fair at all, man can be everything he wants. Woman can be everything she wants. So, the short point, man and a woman was described in terms of capabilities and capacities. See the point, man was described like the lighter. Man is a genius, woman an angel. And we all know that not only man that is existing is a genius.
Yeah.
It can be also the woman. Let's face the reality that not only man is the most powerful. Because we know that woman also can be the most powerful at all, right? So, I therefore conclude that the point is a bias. It was clear there in the point that every description for a man and a woman is unfair.
Thank you for that.
Good afternoon, Madam Chair. As we proceed to our points of perspective, ladies and gentlemen, on the poem entitled Man and Woman, ladies and gentlemen, we will leave a poll that can explain why the poem is not biased, ladies and gentlemen. Man is his own manual, just as woman is her own manual, ladies and gentlemen. and woman, they are far different to each other, diverse as it is. We see no bias in the poem, ladies and gentlemen. The writer used only symbols to be associated with man and woman to emphasize the differences, not bias, ladies and gentlemen. In terms of parenthood, the father stands as a disciplinarian and mother as a caregiver. These two subjects perform different, yet they both work the same goal: to nurture and give what's best for their children. Man has his own characteristics, and also the woman. That would be all.
Thank you. Thank you for that. Now let's hear the
SRT. So good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. So our paradigm believes that this brain has a bias. Bias in a way that different gender has been described, and the one is popping up body another. It was nostalgic to think that 21st century people still see the gender differently, unlike the way before. The opposition might say that each of the characters have been described subdivided because we have different roles, so that it could be equal. But it is really intended to do. Why? It could be a win-win situation where the women and men are described equally. No dominant, no supreme, and fair. It is like you are creating walls and breaking bridges. I will give you a statement that will open your mind. So, man is great and woman is a heart. If man is not capable of loving, if a man is a heart as one. A woman doesn't think, a woman doesn't have a brain at all. Man is capable of loving him, and women are well magical. Even though we are women, we are capable of doing that heroic act. We could be always the downside in this chance that we will always wait for our queens to save us. We can be the hero of ourselves. Man can be a magical, that because he believes and is still fighting. Why it is too selfish for us to tolerate this act? Why it could be that the man has what woman has, and woman has what the man has? Why we keep on taking for granted ourselves in what we deserve? I'm not talking here because I'm a woman, but I'm talking here for a different gender. Start praying well and create bridges. Be strong in this world full of judgment. Be a voice in the world full of criticism, and be a God in this world full of judgment and angry. And that's all you learn from us here.
Now let's listen to the next speaker.
Point.
Order.
Point.
Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Order. Point. Okay, I want to answer your next question.
Thank you.
Thank you. So now, let's give the stage to the next speakers.
Here. So, good afternoon, everyone. In the poem entitled Man and Woman, we do believe that it's not a bias. There is no bias in the poem. First of all, the number described to the matter is the same as the woman. Secondly, how are man and woman described in the poem? Is their own characteristics. For example, a line says there that man is a genius, woman an angel. The man described as a genius, and a genius is a person who has a level of talent or intelligence that is very real or remarkable. The woman described as an angel is a person who is very good and kind. So it's not that only men are geniuses and women aren't. Some women are also geniuses, but it's just that men are known to be in, because you feel that it has something to do with surveys and reports. So if you will ask me that the writer wrote that, it is because of that he also follows the surveys and the reports. And how we were created. So the same as how the woman describes the boy, an angel. It's not that man is not and can be an angel, but it's just that women are known to angel, good and kind.
Hear, hear.
Men are. But it's just that most of the women play the role of being an angel.
Thank you, Miss Peter.
Point, please.
Why is there a genius and an angel? The world was made to have a man and woman. Man and woman are opposite sex or genders. So just like their characteristics, they are opposite with that just. With that,
Miss Speaker, point three.
Okay.
Point
three.
Miss Speaker, how do you differentiate the two, supremacy and preference? Can I ask you a question? With the definition of supremacy and preference, how would you differentiate the two? Yeah. And with the stand firm, as you said, it's fair. How it became fair?
Excuse me? Wait, let me finish first my statement. So just like their characteristics, they are opposite with that just. Not completely like what you think, opposite like beautiful and ugly.
Yes.
But each one of them are playing important
role. Your time has succeeded. Point, please.
Point.
No, it's okay.
Oh, I know what that has to do.
Okay, so for the last speaker, before we proceed, for the members of this house, please observe your attitudes. And that's all. So let's now hear for the last speaker.
Before I would start my statement, this is really detecting bias. The debate is really detecting bias. And
that's really detecting bias.
Before anything else, I would like to give flattering words to this group. You are a perfect judgmental people. Thank you. I would like really to give the flattering words to you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if the other generations, order please, fail to eradicate the problem that everyone is facing right now, would we still make a big failure again? Earlier, I have heard with Rhea, it's fair. The descriptions are all fair. But may I ask you, if your child had read this, if supremacy and preference, and if she would ask you, Mom, what is the difference between supremacy and preference? And your child would said, you tell your children that the supremacy is leadership, while preference is a feeling or liking. Mom, can I be a supreme? Of course. The point is telling you that it's just for description, psychology says. Thank you, Vina, for that one. Psychology says. And you know what, I won't take your point. I will proceed to my, I think it's okay to exceed. This is a dream for betterment of every gender in this nation. Because of toleration of works of every paradigm, and specifically this paradigm, who tolerate the works of Victor Hugo. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank our group had win this debate because as you can see, we give to you that this is a bias and will always be a bias. Wrong things will never be correct and what you fight for or what you fought for is wrong.
Gina, can you please don't focus on the words that I use? Focus and understand what are the words that are used.
Yes, I'm not focusing those words. Thank you. I don't focus with those words because we really focus with the word equal. With the word equal. What do equal mean? Equal means the same way. But supremacy and preference is not the same way. And I'm not specifically with those words. Ladies and gentlemen, I won't take points because I believe we stand and we win this debate. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. To listen to our last debater.
You're here. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, Madam Chair. Who said that woman is inferior to men? Or man is more genius than women? Equality means being equal in value, rank, or ability. And I affirm that the poem clearly implies that men and women are equal. Yes, they've been compared to each other by describing their abilities, but the author was trying to generalize. What are the place of women and men in this world? Such as women described emotionally while men described physically. Men, such as man is the brain. According to science, a man's brain is 11 to 12% bigger than women's brain. But this science has also absolutely nothing to do with intelligence. So, it just suits for the current physics as we read about the trivia I said.
Another example, man is the most elevated of creatures, in the world.
Madam Chair, man is his own manual just as woman is her own manual. So this house is in opposition that there's a bias in the poem Man and Woman written by Victor Hugo. I definitely modify their opinion. So therefore I conclude that the anti-bias wins this debate.
Thank you
for that.
Point, please.
No, you
may
not.
Okay,
thank
points.
You.
It's the end of the debate.
Madam Chair,
close the debate.
Okay, so now, I'm currently...
You may close the house.
Close the debate, so I may now cross the house.
Oh my God, it's like...
Okay, so we're done. Thank you very much, students. It was a good job. You did a good job up here. I would like to commend you for doing your research. Okay, it was a well researched debate. And then I would also, going back to our lesson on, thank you also to our timer and our
Madam Chair.
So, I would like to ask now those who are observers, may I ask, may anyone tell me what side, what team did you side for? Are you in favor of? What team?
The winner is not biased because they actually stated a lot of examples that based on facts that it is usually every man and woman have their own responsibilities.
Okay. Let me hear from this side. Anyone from this side? Which team are you in favor of?
You can like
the Bison.
For me, it is anti-bias because at what they have said, it's just an example, a description for men and women, not to discriminate men and women.
Okay. How about going back to our lesson on adverbs, expressions of affirmation and negation? Was it applied in this debate?
Yes,
it was. Okay, so I would just like to remind you, class, that agreements, disagreements happen every day, no? We converse, we talk every day, and most often we come into agreements and disagreements with somebody. But it is how, it is the manner of talking and the words you use in talking that matters. So be careful with the words you use and be careful with how you express your sentiments and your statements so you will not get into trouble. That is the most important thing in adverbs of negation and affirmation. Again, I would like to commend everybody, especially the both teams. Thank you very much for your cooperation. Let us thank them for hands. Thank you.